In this video, I will cover type 1 and type 2 diabetes mellitus. Diabetes mellitus, commonly referred to as just diabetes, is a chronic metabolic disorder that affects the body's ability to regulate blood glucose levels. Glucose, a simple carbohydrate, is the primary source of energy for the body's cells, and its level in the blood is regulated by a hormone called insulin. In people with diabetes, the body either does not produce enough insulin, type 1 diabetes, or is unable to use insulin effectively, type 2 diabetes. This leads to high levels of glucose in the blood, which can cause a variety of health problems over time, including damage to the kidneys, eyes, nerves, and blood vessels. Let's take a closer look at type 1 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes, also known as insulin-dependent diabetes or juvenile-onset diabetes, is a chronic autoimmune disorder that occurs when the immune system mistakenly attacks and destroys the insulin-producing beta cells in the pancreas. Since insulin regulates glucose, loss of insulin will result in high levels of glucose in the blood, known as hyperglycemia. Here we see exosomes secreted by pancreatic beta cells taken up by dendritic cells from the immune system. The dendritic cells activate T lymphocytes that attack and destroy the beta cells. The exact cause of type 1 diabetes is not fully understood, but it is thought to result from a combination of genetic and environmental factors. Some theories also suggest that a viral infection may initiate an autoimmune response. Since there is no insulin, the body cannot use glucose for energy and instead begins to break down stored fat. This leads to the production of ketone bodies, which can accumulate in the blood and cause a dangerous condition known as diabetic ketoacidosis, DKA, which can lead to coma and death. Symptoms of type 1 diabetes typically develop rapidly and include increased thirst, frequent urination, unexplained weight loss, fatigue, blurred vision, and increased hunger. Management of type 1 diabetes involves insulin replacement therapy, either through injections or an insulin pump, along with regular monitoring of blood glucose levels, adjustment of insulin doses as needed, and dietary and lifestyle modifications. Type 2 diabetes is a chronic condition that results from the body's inability to effectively utilize insulin. This condition is also known as insulin resistance. Type 2 diabetes accounts for the majority of cases of diabetes worldwide. The pathophysiology of type 2 diabetes involves multiple complex mechanisms that ultimately result in high blood glucose levels. For example, in skeletal muscle, heart muscle, adipocytes, fat cells, and other insulin-responsive cells, there are special receptors called glucose transporter 4, or GLUT4. GLUT4 is responsible for the uptake of glucose into these cells from the bloodstream in response to insulin. Here we see how insulin binds with receptors on cell membranes, activating proteins inside the cell that allow for the translocation of the GLUT4 transporter to the cell membrane. The GLUT4 transporter allows glucose into the cell for the production of energy, ATP. In type 2 diabetes, however, the GLUT4 transporters fail to respond to insulin. Glucose cannot be taken into the cell and remains in the blood, causing hyperglycemia and high levels of insulin. Over time, the pancreas may not be able to keep up with the demand for insulin, and insulin production decreases, resulting in chronic hyperglycemia. Additionally, the liver may continue to produce glucose even when blood sugar levels are already high, exacerbating the problem. Another important factor is the presence of chronic low-grade inflammation in the body, which can contribute to insulin resistance. Obesity and excess adipose tissue are associated with increased levels of pro-inflammatory cytokines, which can interfere with insulin signaling. Genetics and environmental factors can also play a role in the development of type 2 diabetes. Environmental factors such as sedentary lifestyle, poor diet, and obesity can further increase this risk. I hope you have learned about diabetes mellitus, and see you next time!